Now, so what we thought we'd do is take another look at Star Wars, which just now broke the United States box office record, which was once held by Gone with the Wind and then by Jaws. Star Wars goes into national re-release for the Christmas season, and for many people that'll be another chance to see those two wonderful non-human friends of ours, the robots R2-D2 and C-3PO. Here we see them in a planetary wasteland.
What a desolate place this is. Where do you think you're going? What mission? What are you talking about? I've just about had enough of you. Go that way. You'll be malfunctioning within a day, you near-sighted scrap pile. And don't let me catch you following me, begging for help, because you won't get it.
The movie is supposed to be set millions and millions of years ago in a galaxy far away, but every time I see it, R2-D2 and C-3PO somehow remind me of Laurel and Hardy. In any event, they may only be robots, but they're the two most sympathetic characters in the film, and it took great special effects to create them. And that's another thing Star Wars and Close Encounters have in common, real magic of combining animation, models, double, triple exposures, and all the other tricks of the special effects trade. Look, for example, at this sensational battle in outer space.
Again, kid?
Okay, stay sharp.
Here they come.
So there you have it. Your basic intergalactic warfare is the heroic princess is snatched away from the Death Star by the intrepid space buccaneers. And what's the meaning of it all? Who knows and who cares? Star Wars became the new box office champion by providing pure 100% escapist entertainment. It's one of those rare movies that seems to play to every sort of audience, Gene, and bring out the kid in all of us.
You know, I've seen the picture 3 times, and that sequence more than that. And every time I see that little fighting sequence, I think I figured out the secret of at least that chunk of the movie, and that is, that looks exactly like what happens at a pinball game that kids love. We're seeing things blow up, and I think the way this movie is shot different ways, quick action like that, it's like you're putting every person as a pinball player who walks into the theater.
Maybe that's why people can see it 12 times or 24 times, because it doesn't matter that you know the story, you still have the sound and light, the effects, the explosions, the dogfight in outer space. It's just a never-ending visual delight. It's a movie that will last for years.
Yeah, the only thing I'm worried about is it's so successful and so mindless fun that I hope Hollywood doesn't forget that there are people who like to see serious pictures, too.